Hello from my hotel room in Missoula, Montana. I wanted to talk very briefly about three books about change in the UK. I think in my video about the gaps in our education when it comes to colonialism and so on in the UK, I mentioned the fact that so much of our history and the way we're taught about activism and change and race and so on is really centered on the US, as though that's the only place where it happens, and misses out all of these vital things in our own history. Not only the empire, but also things like the Bristol bus boycott and the impact of the way that Britain as a country has behaved around the world, what that means for us, what it means to be British. I read three books that deal with this, filling in a lot of the gaps, but also just filling in a lot of the missing voices. The first book that I'm going to talk about is The Good Immigrant, which came out in 2016. 21 writers of colour, black, Asian, minority ethnic writers, talking about what it means to live in Britain, what it means to be in Britain, and what it means in many cases to be British. Each essay is from a different writer, it tackles different perspectives, different problems, different places where people find themselves in this chaos. And one that rang true for me personally, it's called Wearing Where You're At, Immigration and UK Fashion by Sabrina Mahfouz. One of the things that was so impactful for me about that essay, and I feel really emotional even talking about it, is that it verbalised a lot of things that both acknowledge the great privilege of looking white or lighter than many other people, and you know, seeing the horrors that many people endure because of the way that they look, but then also the strange cruelty of having someone dismiss your identity and say to your face the things that they assumed about you because of your name, while kind of ignoring the fact that they're still saying about people you know, but also about, you know, your people. But there are all sorts of different essays, many of which don't apply to my personal experience, that are so valuable. And that for me was the biggest takeaway of The Good Immigrant. I want this to be read by a lot of people who are white and who are very, very white British, and you know, their mother's British and their mother's mother's British and their mother's 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 British. Quite a few actors contributed to this and talk about their experience going into auditions and what the role that they're expected to play, and how even success doesn't take away from that, you know, like doesn't take away from how you're seen by people. I think sometimes when we talk about the assumptions people make about other people of other races, of other genders, of other abilities, of other languages and so on, it's with a certain amount of distance and without that more, I suppose, intimate look at how that affects someone's life and how it sticks with them. So that's The Good Immigrant. That was edited by Nikesh Shukla, who is working on this project called The Good Journal right now, who has this Kickstarter. It's going to be a quarterary magazine of writing by writers of colour in the UK. By the time I upload this, it's probably going to have about 2 days left. If you can contribute, please do. If you're low income or a student, there's a discounted subscription. There's also digital print subscriptions, tote bags, higher level sponsorships and so on. I think it's really important to have these voices amplified. Just having this conversation in so all the different ways that we need to have it, and showing all of the ways that our current conversation is incomplete. The next book is Lobbying for Change, Find Your Voice to Create a Better Society. This is by Alberto, Alemanno. I've always thought of lobbyists as like a separate higher up entity, but the truth is we can all be lobbyists. Part of what this book was is a primer in how to do that, providing both the technical understanding of what it means to be a lobbyist, what it means to be an activist, but also the many different ways that you can request information, the many different types of things that you can lobby for and against, and for me was just so helpful in understanding how my country works. So for example, we've all been sent, and many of us have signed, I'm sure, petitions. But in the petition section, it gives you guidelines of all the different things that you need to know about what you're going to include in the petition, and breaks down the advantages and disadvantages of different kinds of protest. So for example, on the petition section it says, although a petition is only as meaningful as its response, it allows blocks of public interest to form, harnessing power in ways that may lead to a legislative or administrative response. But then there are also lots of different case studies of things that have worked and haven't worked, and the kinds of change that have happened. But that for me was a great starting point. And then the last one is A Change Is Gonna Come, which I think is probably geared slightly younger. This is a collection of stories and poetry about change from 12 writers, 12 black, Asian, minority ethnic British writers. It's not that long of a read, and the text is quite big as well. So I was already thinking of people that I wanted to give this to for Christmas, who might not have seen themselves reflected in what they're reading, or who might not know that their reading is quite narrow. One of the things that has given me so much hope in this time that I've felt upset a lot of the time is seeing how engaged so many young people are in creating change and in wanting to make a difference, and how they're organizing themselves in different ways to make that change a reality. So I think that books like this and the fact that the publishing industry or parts of the publishing industry are listening to the people in their industries who are saying, this is not enough, we're not doing enough, we're not including enough voices, and also the people outside of the industry who haven't been included, all finding their own roots for it. I think that there are publishing houses that are doing really exciting things and starting up and finding their own voices. And I'll talk about more about that in the future. Change is happening, and there are people telling you how to make better change and that we can listen to and learn from and organize with. And that to me is something worthy of celebration and worthy of hope and worthy of continued hard work. Because reading broadly and reading books like these aren't about, you know, patting yourselves or me patting myself on my back and saying, oh yeah, I listened to that one time. It's about changing our approach to things and what we think of as realms in which we can use our influence and use our platforms to do something different. So anyway, that's just three. And now I've got to go to Spokane. Don't forget to check out the Good Journal Kickstarter. Okay, good. Bye.